In this video, I'm going to demonstrate to you how to give a programming assignment which involves file operations in the Moodle platform. So click add an activity or resource like any other activity you are doing in Moodle. As you are giving programming assignment, just click virtual programming lab. So give the basic details, name of the name you would like to give to your program. So this is the name which I would like to give to my program. And give description for that particular program. So once you're done with this one, one thing should be particular about this programming assignment is you should take care of the submission restrictions. So generally any programming assignment which does not involve file operations, so maximum number of files is one is enough. That one is for typing our program. Now you are working, you know, you would like to give a programming assignment which involves files. So here you have to increase the number of files. So in this particular, for my program, I will have to give 4 test cases and each test case involves one text file. So 1 plus 4 is 5. I need 5 files. What are 5 files? One file is for typing my program and the remaining 4 files for my 4 test cases. So click save and display. Now we would like to upload our files. Okay. Click the actions button and click the execution files. These 4 files, vpl, run, debug, evaluate and evaluate test cases, these 4 files are default files, don't disturb them. And if you would like to add your text files, add by clicking the plus button. Click the plus button and click this button, import button. So if you click import button, you will get file explorer. These are my 4 test cases. So these 4 files are my 4 test cases. Just upload them. Save it. Now we upload the files. We uploaded 4 files. These 4 files should be available while a student evaluates his program. So go to actions. Click this one, files to keep while running. So whatever the files you uploaded, that files will be appeared here. Just select all the 4 files. So these 4 files will be available to the student when he is executing his program. I click save. So we have given a question and we have uploaded text files. Then let us use the test cases. Again, go back to the settings. Click the test cases button. Here you have to give test cases like any other program. Okay, so for this program I am giving 4 test cases, and the input for the first test case is the file name, and for second test case and third test case and fourth test case also, these are file names. These are the 4 files which I uploaded just sometime before. And this is my expect output for each file. Expect output for each file as test cases. We are done with this one. Let us check whether it is working or not. Test whether your assignment is working properly or not. Click test activity button, click edit, write your program here for that respective assignment. So for my assignment, this is my program. It is always a better idea to use inverted search while reading a line of text. So this is nothing but read and up to n and immediately ignore the new line character and evaluate your program. We are done with this one. All the 4 test cases are passed.